So next session, subject code 19 MA203, complex variable and differential equations. Unit number 5, application of partial differential equations. So in this topic we will discuss about one dimensional heat equations with zero boundary conditions. So this is the next session of this unit. So before we already saw the one dimensional wave equations, zero velocity and non-zero velocity. The next thing is one dimensional heat equations, zero boundary conditions. Next one is non-zero boundary conditions. So first we can discuss about zero boundary conditions. So the partial differential equations of one dimensional heat flow equations is dou u divided by dou t equal to a square dou square u by dou x square. So in one dimensional wave equations, both are like a second degree. For in this case, one is a linear degree, one is a second degree. So be careful here. So one dimensional heat flow equations, dou u divided by dou t equal to a square dou square u divided by dou x square, where a square equal to k divided by rho into c, that is thermal conductivity divided by density into specific heat. So k is a thermal conductivity, rho is a density, c is a specific heat of the given one dimensional heat equations. So these are definitions and possible solutions. So here is the potential derivatives. Dou u divided by dou x is a rate of change of temperatures with respect to t. Distance is called the temperatures gradient. So this is a definition of temperatures gradient. So this is a possible solution of one dimensional heat equations. Number one, u of x comma t equal to c1 e power px plus c2 e power minus px into c3 e power a square p square t. Number one. Number two, u of x comma t equal to c4 cos px plus c5 sin px into c6 e power minus a square p square into t. And last one is u of x comma t equal to c7 plus c8 into a9. So what is the possible solution here? First one is like a there is exponential form. So these we are not able to find the solutions. Last one is line equations, that is also not satisfied. Therefore current solution is equation number 2. This is a current solution for one dimensional heat flow equations. So next we have to find the conditions here. So these are one dimensional heat equations, dou u divided by dou t equal to a square dou square u by dou t dou x square. The boundary conditions are: number one, u of x comma t equal to k1 degree c, that is u of 0 comma t equal to k1 degree c. Then number two is u of x l comma t equal to k2 degree c. The initial condition is u of x comma t is f of x. For in this conditions we are using only 3 boundary conditions. For previous one we find 4, but in heat flow equations 3 is enough to finding the final solutions. So first one is u of 0 comma t equal to first degree, then second one is u of l comma t equal to second degree, then initial condition is u of x comma t, that is t equal to 0, is equal to f of x. So these are how to find the steady state conditions here. The steady state condition is nothing but the heat flow equations is dependent of time t. So time t is dependent means, that is dou u by dou t equal to 0 means, that is a steady state conditions, that is second derivative is also 0. Therefore u of x equal to c1x plus c2. So these are main equations to find the functions, u of x equal to c1x plus c2. Then thermal conductivity is nothing but the temperature gradient is 0 at the point, that is dou u by dou x equal to 0, that is a thermal conductivity. That is, if an end of heat conductive body is thermally insulated, it means that no heat passes through the sections, that is a thermal insulator. That is dou u by dou x equal to 0. So this is the main one, main things you have to find the u of x equal to c1x plus c2. These are functions finding in the one dimensional heat flow equations. So first we can pass on to the problem number one. A rod of length L has its ends capital A and capital B kept at 0 degree Celsius and 120 degree Celsius respectively. If the temperature at B is raised to 0 degree C and kept that A is maintained, so same thing, then find the resulting temperature distributions U of x, t taking the origin at capital A. So here is the rod is given 0 to L, that is a length, 0 to L is a rod. A and B are heat temperatures. For A is given is 0 degree Celsius, B is 120 degree Celsius. Then write down the one dimensional heat flow equations, dou u by dou t equal to A square dou square u by dou x square. It is, don't write the three equations, one is enough. The correct solution is u of x, t equal to A4 cos px plus A5 sin px into A6 e power minus A square p square t. First you find the conditions here. First we go through the steady state conditions. What is steady state conditions? Dou u by dou t equal to 0 means the derivative, second derivative equal to 0. Therefore equation is u equal to ax plus b. Then put given that u equal to 0 when x equal to 0, first conditions. So we get b equal to 0. So u equal to 0, first condition is 0. So b equal to 0, first one is x equal to 0 is given. So therefore b equal to 0. Second condition is u equal to 120 degree Celsius. That is second one. First one is u equal to 0, x equal to 0. Second one is u equal to 120, x equal to L. Therefore, we get AL plus B equal to 120. Therefore, AL equal to 120. Therefore, A equal to 120 divided by L into x. So, we know that A and B value. Substitute in the third conditions. So, we get u equal to 120 x divided by L plus 0. So, that is 120 divided by x. L into x. Therefore, after the steady state conditions, the temperature is reduced to 0 degree Celsius. Therefore, the boundary conditions are number 1, u of 0, t equal to 0. Number 2, u of L, t equal to 0. Number 3, u of x, 0. That is f of x. What is f of x? 120 divided by L into x. So, these are conditions for finding the solutions. What is the current solutions? The boundary conditions. U of x, t equal to a cos px plus b sin px e power minus a square p square t. These are correct solutions. As usual procedures, apply 1 in 1. So put x equal to 0, cos 0 is 1, sin 0 is 0. So we get a into e power minus a square p square t equal to 0. So this one is not equal to 0, only the constant must be in 0. Therefore a equal to 0. Substitute a equal to 0 in equation number 1. So we get u of x, t equal to b sin px into e power minus a square p square t. Next, apply 2 in second conditions. Put x equal to L. So we get b sin p L e power minus a square p square t equal to 0. Then yes, b is not equal to 0. Y means this one is 0 means whole thing must be vanishes. Therefore, only thing is exponential form is also not equal to 0. Therefore, only thing is sin PL equal to 0. Then PL equal to n pi. Therefore, P equal to n pi by L. Substitute P value in equation number 2. Therefore, u of x, t equal to b sin n pi x divided by L into e power minus a square. So, n square pi square by L square into t. So, replace the P square value. Then write the general solution for these equations. Therefore, u of x, t equal to summation n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x divided by L into e power minus a square n square pi square divided by L square into t. That is equation number 3. Next, applying 3 in 3, put t equal to 0. So, put t equal to 0 means what is e power 0? That is 1. So, we get summation n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x by L, that is equal to f of x. What is f of x? 120 divided by x divided by L. Then next to find the bn value by using half friend sign series. So therefore bn equal 2 by L integral 0 to L f of x sin n pi x divided by L into dx. Then put f of x equal to 120 x divided by L sin n pi x by L into dx. Bernoulli's formula you can apply. First I can kept here is I can take 120 by L outside, so 240 by L square. So I can fix x as it is. Integration of sine is minus cos n pi x divided by l whole divided by n pi by l minus differentiation of x is 1. Again integration of cos is minus sine n pi x divided by l divided by n pi by l whole square. Put upper limit x equal to l here. So when putting x equal to l means cancelling l and l, so we get cos pi. That is, what is cos n pi? Minus 1 whole power n. Put x equal to l means sine n pi is 0. Put x equal to 0 means sine is vanishes. Then put x equal to 0 means this also vanishes. So only we get minus l into l divided by n pi. So cancelling l square here, therefore bn equal to 240 divided by n pi minus 1 whole power n plus 1. So that is the required solution. Substitute bn value in equation number 3. Therefore u of x comma t equal to summations n equal to 1 to infinity 240 divided by n pi minus 1 whole power n plus 1 into sine n pi x by l into e power minus a square p square pi square t divided by l square. Okay, so these are final solutions for the given problem. So this is a very very important one, so be careful here. So using the diagram you are able to find the solutions of this problem. So diagram is a very very important one. So this diagram, then again this diagram also is important one, then these are original things. So be careful here. So in here is there is zero conditions, so 0 degree Celsius is given. Sometimes this one is not given, so a and b are kept to some degree Celsius, then a is raised, b is decreased, like that means that is non-zero problem. So that one is continuing in the next sessions. Okay, thank you.